Good afternoon, everybody. So I'm gonna start off looking at some assessed-based versions here. So this one's got like a green over where the recessed face is. It's exact opposite of the one below me here. You see how they're pretty much the same, except this one's facing to the right. This one here with the recessed face, the eye, nose, and everything, however it comes out, it's recessed face all right here, and then this is a large headdress. Pretty neat. So this is the repeating pattern. Show a couple different versions of this here. You can see it right here. Recessed face again, tall headdress, little pointy one. Take a look at some of the sandstone with you. I'll zoom in for it. So, look at the shadows and things. You can see the etch marks, big eye right here, the circle. See it all etched in there still. So there's eyes and things etched into this maybe sandstone. Lots of different images when you point it different ways. You can see all these little eyes and triangles popping out of here. Those aren't just lines, these are actually designs on the stone. Big eye right there. There's lots of eyes all over the thing. Even little tiny ones. See these little tiny itty bitty ones? Notice the rest of the stone doesn't have that. There's a couple different eyes, but see all these. So yeah. Pretty cool, right? So let's go ahead and take a look at some more. I think I can give you a little more evidence as well. So these are small versions, again, recessed face, little eye inside there. Similar stone here. Of course, same profile to the left. This one is probably a giant bird head in some which way. Recessed beak is usually what they have. So yeah, to me in this picture here, like a big old goose head, like its eye would be there, his eye would be there. Big duck head. You can see the way the stone is shaped, like a triangle. The neck is recessed there, the beak is recessed, some three levels. And then just the top section there would be like a duck beak perhaps, that being the eye, but there's also the archetype of the diamond shaped fella. So he's like that. You see how his hair right up here gets like wavy and everything? That's him, he's one of the archetypes. You can even see his eye coming in really well right there now. As you tilt him, you can see all the definition come out. Look at that crazy eye. Pretty insane, right? Now everyone sees these things in rocks, right? Can't miss it when it's this high definition. There's another eye right here. You see that? Give you a little time. If you really want to get crazy with it, you can start making the faces out of it. Learn how to understand this ancient art. It's pretty amazing. It's a pretty amazing thing. Look at that bird beak right there, his eye. Yep. So this is the other side, of course. Different things all over this. You can go ahead and move on to another one if you want to, but this is again the recessed face right here. Like that crest. Go ahead and look at a couple more of those. Some of these have very defined things on them. You can see all the carvings and things. Little eyelashes, other eyes. Some eye, there's styles to the eyes, so there's a couple different kinds. This, of course, is a cardinal. You see the top of his crest right here, his beak, and his eyes carved in right there. It's a little cardinal, a little bird effigy. Also several other things. A person right here with like the big nose, big chin variant. Also different ones, but see this big round shape here with the pupil here. A lot of things going on with this. Go ahead and take a look at one more. I'll try to leave some for the next time. the like bird head, you can see the carving right there, the circle, the triangle shaped eye. It's gonna be a lot of different things. This looks like maybe another bird with a crest here. Who knows? Be some other animal. Oh, big beak with the crest facing to the left, and that would be the eye in here. One of those like crested, it's all the crest right there. Wow, very neat. You guys want more? Real quick, we'll do this one. This one's also one of those sandstone ones. And so you'll be able to see and get the shadows right. Up here is where we're looking. I mean, there's stuff all over it too, but if I can get the shadows straight for us. This is another little head statue, and it's got some pretty good carved and stuff. It's a little, probably a little wet right now. Sorry, I thought that one's a little more recognizable, but here's a really good one. So again, recessed face, headdress. You can see the way the headdress is shaped. And then if you look closely, you'll be able to see the eye, like very detailed right in there. Look at some more stuff. You see the eyes, I hope. This is all headdress right here. Let's look at some different ways and we'll be able to spot out. You just kind of put the faces together. So this guy, just looking at, there's so many. You guys can spot them out. I'm gonna go into overload if I keep trying to describe. It's a very neat one. A lot of the archetypes. There's that diamond head archetype again. The flat top, there's a lot of different ones. But you guys might be able to pick up on some of these ridges and etching that's on here, if anything else. This whole thing right here is a big eye, looks like. See the ridges going down it. These were all packed in clay. Look at all these eyes. Kind of looking at it upside down, perhaps, but it's not, there's no upside down. But for this eye there, probably, you know, the one right there, another one right there. You see the, looks like the sun, little lines coming out of it. All right, guys, take care. Have a great one.